international foundation of science for about 30 years. After doing that, I became their scientific advisor in the area of science, and I'm still one of their scientific advisors. Beyond that, I need to let you know my background that I've been teaching in the Department of Science and Technology.
Towards achieving
some desired outcomes or goals. This is the reason. This is the focus from which we've been looking at progress. So what I'm saying is that go to Abeokuta City today and you see the type of things that Governor Amusu is doing in town. What Governor Amusu is doing in town today is a project. You agree? The scientist who stays in the laboratory and is carrying out the research is also doing a project, because both of them, what they are doing is that they are making use of some resources. They are also making use of the abilities of some human resources and committing them to achieve a desired goal. But the common definition of a project that many people look at is that projects are about work, I agree. It's about action, it's about building, it's about rebuilding, it's about achievements, it's about delivering goals, it's about outcome. I want to believe that all these terms that I've mentioned so far, they are the terms that have come up in the course of the lecture of yesterday's morning on how to write a project proposal. Let me note that some of the issues that have been mentioned today, they are, some of them may be similar to those things that have been mentioned in the lecture of yesterday's morning. Then if I look at it, that simply, what is a project? They are the activities that you embark upon to produce a product, to produce a service, or to produce resource. So, put it another way, a project is a task with a known endpoint. And if you've gone to different people and asked them, what is a project? I know that if I go to an engineer and ask the engineer what is a project, the engineer will tell me. If ever I've gone to somebody who studies theater arts and ask the person what is a project, by the way, as a university Nigerian now, the person having the highest number of international grants in that university is somebody who studies theater arts. How was it really doing it? It just packages theater arts and tailor this into medicine without being a medical doctor. The package is set as to tailor it into other professions that are different from his own. There are projects that he has embarked upon. So a project is a task with a known endpoint. I'm just giving you these three definitions. I want you to look at it. These are the definition of three different people about what the project is. Somebody said, a project is a series of tasks with a beginning and an end, conducted by people to meet established goals within parameters of cost, schedule, and quality. Indeed, that first one is the standard definition or the academic definition of what a project is. Another person says a project is a unique venture, normally associated with a set of people, product of procedures, and other resources temporarily assembled to reach specific objective, normally with a fixed budget and with a fixed time period. Another person is saying it's an organized work towards a predefined goal objective that requires resources and efforts and have a budget and a schedule. Please and gentlemen, let me dispose of yours. Are we all saying the same thing? Yes. The truth of the matter is that you find that in the definition there are many things that are common. And all that these three definitions are saying is what I have to present in this, in that whenever we mention the word project, we are talking about some activities that demands that some people should put effort. When we talk about project, we are talking about activities. Project must always have a time span, a time frame. Before you can say that you are doing a project, it must have clearly defined objectives. Not just the objectives alone, a project must have clearly defined partners. And there's no project that you will do that will not involve cost or not demand that resources be involved in. And lastly, there's no project without risk. Every project must have a risk. Indeed, if you say that you are a project manager, what you are really doing is that we are somebody managing human beings. You are somebody managing resources. You are somebody managing money. You are also somebody managing time. And lastly, you are a risk manager. Indeed, our life is a life of risk. If you cannot stand up to risk, you will not be a good project manager. And in doing this, what really have I said so far? All that I'm saying is that when we talk about projects, when we talk about projects, it's about doing some activities in order to achieve some outcomes. Doing some activities in order to achieve some outcomes. But in doing these activities, if you've not been trained in some very important aspect of project management, you'll probably be a failure. For example, in doing those activities, it should demand you need to do what I call planning. Along with planning is scheduling. During scheduling, there must be control and then management for you to achieve your desired outcome. I will tell you, the story is not as easy as this. The first time I was asked to manage a project for the DFID. It was a project of about 300 million pounds sterling, and I must spend it within 3 years. And it's decided that if I fail to spend it within 3 years, I return the money. I put up the first proposal, the first call. I was able to get 120 calls. And by the time I look at the 120 calls, all that I saw in the proposal are people applying. Yes, you are a professor of chemistry, focusing only on chemistry issues. Professor of biology, focusing and really focusing. And one of the facts I will be told today is that you cannot go far if you are working alone. And that's why it's high time we make friends with ourselves by working together. The type of team I was looking for, I'm looking for a project that involves people in the sciences, people in the social, including social sciences, people in history, people in political sciences. And I should also tell you, there is almost no project that will be a real project if there is no economist. Because no matter what you do, everything boils down to money. And that's why, by the time you start to put up the people you are going to work with together, don't just pick up anybody. Choose the type of people that you need to build it up. For example, now, if I have to write a proposal now, to anything in Europe. The policy in Europe, all that we are being here about, men, women, female, 50-50. There must be 50% representation of female of the gender in your proposal. If you cannot make it, it's your business. In fact, they will not even open your proposal if some things are not in place, and I believe that these are the issues that must have been discussed. But the area I'm dealing with today is that you are a good writer. You're a good thinker. You also know how to bring people together in the proposal. And you won that grant. Like somebody, when I gave out my first grant, so many people won the grant. But within 3 months of winning the grant, I had to write a university in Zimbabwe. No, Mozambique. I wrote a university in Mozambique. that I was giving the person there 1 month to account for the money I've given him. If not, I'm going to withdraw the grant from him. Why did I do that? By the time the person brought up the first report, 3 months, I gave him a project for 9 months. And I expected him to be reporting to me every 3 months. By the time he brought the first report, all that I found in his activity is transportation and tear off. And I was wondering, his research, transportation, here, tea and coffee. And the person couldn't understand. I withdrew that project from that person. But you may think that I've just withdrawn the project from one person. I've withdrawn that project from the whole of that university. And one good thing with people who support project is that they talk to each other. They want to know that it's a network. They talk to each other. So if they plan, if a researcher in this university gets a grant, even as an individual, and fail to execute that grant, you jeopardize the opportunity of every one of us in this university from getting that grant. And that's why the issue I'm putting here is that by the time you've written your project proposal, we are excited, I've won the project, I've won the grant. That's where the enthusiasm that comes up within a short time may really result to chaos. And when that chaos comes up, it's not only you that will be punished for your inability to deliver. The whole of the university may be at risk. And that's why by the time I now talk of the international best practices, you'll be able to understand this. And the summary of what I've said is that the work we've done so far in this course is very good. We've taught ourselves how to write beautiful project proposal. But that is just the beginning. The real work about research is the management of that project. And that's what I'm focusing on today. Why is it that people get projects, they get grants, but they are not able to succeed with it? And what is needed is the focus of this presentation. I'm discussing with you today what is needed to make a success of the grant that you have won. And what is needed is simply put, that you need the ability to plan, schedule, and control your project activities in order to achieve your project objectives. And this input is what we call project management. What can we do as researchers that after writing our proposal and winning the grant, we are able to plan, to schedule, to control project activities to achieve project objectives? I will tell you, it was until I left this country and went out that I found out that the work we are doing in university is very important in our development. Many of us who do the research, when you ask us what we are doing, we say we are doing projects. Our understanding of project is, let me do experiment, get results, and when I get results, publish paper that will earn me promotion, and that is the end. The understanding of project to those of us in this part of the world is quite different from what the project is outside this place. I've seen people who are academics. Because of the strength of their country, they are not concerned about promotion. They are just focused on how to help their people. Indeed, there are countries where our academics here, we are lucky. Sorry that I have to say this out. There are countries where there's a lady in UK. She has even promised to come to this university to give us one lecture. This lady is a chemist. But you need to see how this lady thinks. She's a chemist with a passion. She takes her chemistry to the secondary school to meet with young girls. She wanted young girls to become chemists like her. She moves over all over the country to share her passion. She told me that she told her university not to pay her salary again. that she has so learned that it will be a loss on her to depend on university salaries. Because the project money that she's making every year is enough to support her. Such a person understands what it means to manage projects. And that's why I try to highlight some of the problems of academics in Africa. For example, many of us do not know that the future of this country depends on us. Really. If this country we have to move ahead, if we have to be competitive, if we will not be wasting our money to import rice, if we will not be able to be wasting our money to depend on China, we may need to change our thinking. Every one of us will be talking that we are in a knowledge economy. Here, it is what you know and what you do with what you know that is important, not your natural resources. And therefore, academics are important. The second challenge we are facing in Africa today is about funds. And I know that many of us will be happy with that, saying that the fund that we have is limited. And let me tell you too, today, there is a lot of research funds residing in debt funds for universities which cannot be assessed. And this is why it cannot be assessed, is that our elders, 4 or 5 years ago, who got the first debt fund research grant, they've collected the money, they've pocketed it, they've not done the research, they've not accounted for it, and subsequently, they cannot assess it again. There are many universities today who have debt fund research money that cannot be assessed because they won the receipt 3 years ago, they won't make reports. And the vice chancellor has gone, and there's still nobody to challenge anybody to pick up anything. And therefore, that place is locked up. And when you look at it, what is really wrong? It's not that they cannot write a proposal. They've written the proposal. The problem is they find it difficult to manage the project. And what I'm trying to sensitize you now is that please, there are some skills that we will not be taught in school. There are some skills that will not go along with your certificates. There are some skills that those of us who are academics will look at and say we need these skills. And can pick up these skills by picking up books to read about it. One of those skills that those of us who are researchers will pick up is that of project management. And I know that there are shortcuts all over the country and outside on project management. And it's high time we subscribe to it. Project management is a wide area, which I know that I cannot go through within just 2, 3 hours or 1 hour, two. But all I'm doing today is that I want to say special to the importance of ability to manage projects after you won the project. And this is one skill area that is missing in our country today, research project management. So I'll just make an effort now just to sensitize us about what project management is. What really is project management? Project management is the application of knowledge, skills, tools, and techniques to project activities in order to meet project requirements. Or if I put it another way, project management is a skill or a field of moving from ideas to results. I know what I want to get. I have the idea. Project management is the planning, the scheduling, the controlling, the risk management of activities in order to achieve project objectives. In doing this, so many things will be required of the individual in what I call the project management system. The thing is, after you written your proposal, there are some skills that you need to have in mind to succeed as a project manager or as a successful researcher. The first one is that of leadership. And what we are getting to do now is that to succeed as a researcher in university, you need to build up yourself to be a leader. And the concept of leadership involves ability to negotiate, ability to build teams, ability to communicate, ability to motivate. I remember Dr. Adebayo should be in this room. About around 1992, 93, 95, when we started one day by the project on cassava with Professor Dikolo, we used to lock ourselves up in one, we went and hired one hotel room around Utah, and we will do night vigil. All of us. And what we are doing is brainstorming. Brainstorming on what to do. We are from different fields, economists, social scientists, and others. The only thing we do not have is the historians. And if I have my way now, I will have the person who studied drama to join us. For a study group to come to be, there should be a leader. That's leadership. Ability to say, I don't mind who you are, I don't mind your religion, I don't mind your gender. All I'm interested in is what you can bring to the student. That is one of the things that we need for project management. The second skill that we need in project management is that of planning. Basic goals, where you set visions, goals, strategies. We should be strategists, so strategic in our operations. And the third skill is the one many of us like, techniques and methodologies. Because all that one needs is we stay in elaboration, do the work. The success in research goes beyond the ability to carry out techniques and methodologies in physics, chemistry, biology, or even other areas of sciences. And last and thirdly, you also need a level of ability to control. You control people. If you fail to control people, you will get out of hand. Control situations, because in doing projects, not everything will work your way. Then you need some organization ability. And in talking about is ability to take responsibility, ability to be accountable. And the last one is something that many of us do not take note of, ethics. I gave this lecture some time ago, and I said that every researcher, you need to have some values in life. The first time I got to work in Accra, within 2 weeks of my getting there, I was surprised. They just put up a force on Saturday. They said, Saturday and Sunday, none of you should go. Put all of us in a vehicle, and we went to a village in Accra. And we camped ourselves there. And we're asking ourselves questions. What does this association stand for? If somebody called me today, what are the values of this institution that I can stand for, I can defend? Ladies and gentlemen, institutions that come to me today, they have values. Values are things that drive your operations and your activities. And when you set those values, it should be communicated to everybody. In Accra, we put our values on the wall and we stand by it. It's high time that we have institutional values. Individuals too should have values. And one of the values that I believe that we should have is the value of excellence. Value of commitment to whatever your plan finds to do is a value. And without all these things, it's the lack of these things that has affected many people. Sorry, I came in to the director of the Advanced Management Enterprise. I was appointed January this year. And the first project they brought to me, Atlantic University is here. By the time I look at the whole thing, I just told the person that this project cannot succeed. Why? In the proposal, I saw that you want to buy cutlass for $1,000. No, they approved it. Come right there, they approved it. But I just told the person that me, cutlass, I will buy $1,000 cutlass. No. And I think the BBC academic was here. I wrote a memo. I did this in development. I wrote a memo to him to tell him that I don't think that this people will succeed. All that I've just done is to assess that proposal on the basis of value. Those people who succeed today are people who have strong values. In the international world today, you succeed if your value is strong. You see, in the international world, if you steal a cobalt, they will treat you as if you are stealing a million. And that single cobalt they will not teach you in pay for life. They will not repent. And that's why it's high time we set values for our lives. So, in summary, what I'm trying to say here is that in our African system, this is where we are strong on. This is where we got our PhD on. But life is more than your techniques and methodologies. In fact, by the time you get to the level of being a professor, there should be some leadership skills in your life. I was talking to somebody not long ago. Some small boys just shook the person a little. Professor. And the next thing he said is, I'm resigning. And I just looked at it and said, then I'm going to ask you. Life, you should be ready for those shaking. It's part of what builds you up. So, that's what project management is all about. Then behind what I'm saying, the rain mover, the person at the core of the managing of the project, it's not everybody. If we put up a project now, that project will not succeed if all of us want to manage the project together. There must be a leader. So for every project that will succeed, though that project may be a project involving a team, the successful execution of that project depends on the leadership that is provided. Sorry that I'm digressing a little. I'm just wanting to seize this opportunity to share with you my ideas of what leadership is. To me, leadership is the art of getting us to do something that we should be done. That's leadership. You believe that something should be done. Ability to consent to do what should be done is leadership. Professor Dikoli was joking about me not long ago. When we started our cassava food project, I just came to them and said, we are getting millions. That we must build a structure with that money. And they just told me, they said, but it's not here in the project, it's not there. And I told them, this year nobody is going to get any budget. All of you bring your budget. We commit to create that project. That's leadership. Leadership is empowering others and showing them the way to be blessed. To the extent that if you call yourself a professor today and you've not helped others to rise up, you're a useless professor. Ability to empower others, show them the way. And that's why one of the things we need to start to concentrate upon today is ability to mentor others. The strength of your life as a professor. I was in university in Germany. And I just saw this professor is always on his table. He won't go to classes. And I was asking, when it's time for a lecture, the graduate student will take it up. And I asked, why are you here? I said, what I'm here for is to make sure that I get money for these young ones to be able to do their project. He's always planning. He's always looking for research grants. And that is one of the things that professors should be happy to do now. Let's be the one to be looking for research grants. We are not the one that will go to the laboratory again. But get research grants that will help our young ones to move ahead in life. What is leadership? Leadership is dreaming. And making others to own your own dream. You dream, that's the leader. But you now sell your dream to some people. By the time you sell to them, you now sit back. You will not be the one you will see again. You will be surprised how those people you sold the dream to will now carry the dream as it is. And that leadership must have some responsibilities. As the leader for a project, you are responsible for selection of the project to do, define what it's about, plan it, control it, get the necessary outputs or feedbacks, take the risk, and close it out. These are the functions of the leader in the project. And for that leader, each of these activities that I've mentioned are so important to ensure that the project is well managed. For example, when we talk about project management, it has about 5 or 6 fundamental activities. That is, the first one is defining what that project is about. It helps to establish a common understanding of the goal and constraints of the project. Where you decide, this is the topic you want to work upon. These are the stakeholders you want to focus on. Who are the people that can sponsor this project? You develop a relationship with them, and then you go ahead. Following that, you do some planning. I want to believe that some of these must have been discussed yesterday. Where you have the detailed description of the work. This, doing this, I realize that people may think that some of us will be focusing this on research projects. But talking about project management goes beyond research projects. Look at it as if you want to build a house. It's a project. The same thing that you need in building a house may almost be the same thing that you need in executing a project. The planning, that will be the control. Because there is no project without some challenges. And you now need to be able to ensure control. You need to have decided on some monitoring parameters that should be in place. And as a leader, you should be able to communicate with the project and stakeholders on developments along the project. And as I mentioned, there are some things. Indeed, I hope so that in your yesterday, in writing a project proposal, one of the things that people often do is that your proposal may be excellent. The last component of a project proposal is risk management. You should be able, even before you start the project, envisage the risk that you are expecting. I think that what those ones mentioned yesterday. Project proposal should not be complete if there is no section on risk management. And what the person that you project management will do is to sit and say that what are the likely risks that I will encounter in doing this project for the next 12 months or 18 months or 24 months. And before you start, you must tell yourself, you must think up the risk and tell yourself action that you will take should any of those risks come up. And that gives the person who wants to fund you the assurance that even if there's a problem, this person will take care of it. For example, if I secure any project here today, one of the risks I will probably put there is instability in our calendar. it exists at least. Those are the type of risk. Then, quality management. And in terms of that, we talk of the meeting, the ensuring that you can